Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at ValderBeebeShow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/ValderBeebeShow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good day and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show, or rather, welcome to the Valder Beebe Show this morning. I'm sorry, I'm so confused because it's Friday and I just found out, so I'm so excited. So my first guest is going to be Cassidy Blackwell. She's the director of the International Communications for Airbnb. And you guys know I love a good Airbnb. And she's here going to give us some information about, I know you've been cooped up, but you got plans on getting out there. Cassidy Blackwell, welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show.
Thanks, Valder. So excited to be back here with you this morning.
Well, guests are, a potential guest for Airbnb, they're increasingly planning their summer travel. They're opting to go off the beaten path. So tell me, how are guests seeking to emerge off the beaten path destinations after this lockdown?
Absolutely. So, Valder, you mentioned it. People have been cooped up for over a year. And as a result, we anticipate a once-in-a-lifetime travel rebound. And we're seeing that travelers are trading crowded cities, they're trading the houses that they've been stuck in for the last year, and they're using Airbnb to book open-air adventures in the great outdoors. So for many people, Memorial Day, as we know, is the unofficial start to summer, and we're already starting to see things heat up for the rest of the season. So right here in Texas, searches for more remote destinations have increased by 24% in March compared to 2019. That means we're seeing people search for farm stays in the countryside or cabins next to national and state parks. And for people who are looking for a lot of space, get this, we actually just listed an entire mountain on Airbnb. An entire mountain. It's so cool. It's in Big Sky, Montana. It's got 6,000 acres of private access for just two people. It's absolutely an experience of a lifetime. It's hosted by a world famous mountaineer named Conrad Anker. It's going to be very, very cool. So after that year that we've had sheltering in place, self-isolating, people are getting back to travel and they're going to off the beaten path destinations where they can get up close and personal with nature and immerse themselves in these wide open spaces.
So these farm stays and glamping and rent your own mountain, these one-of-a-kind experiences, they're very popular.
Absolutely, absolutely. People are taking a lot of advantage of getting into nature and experiencing something new, something fresh, something green. It's definitely a travel trend that we're seeing of people getting into more remote and rural destinations.
Well, so what are some of the top international destinations on the traveler's wish list?
Well, we have seen some really interesting guidance about Europe allowing Americans back this summer. But actually what we're seeing is that people are still feeling really comfortable staying a little bit closer to home. So we call those nearby stays, driving distance, where people can hop in the car, take advantage of flexibility to go 100-300 miles away from home. Some people are feeling a little bit more comfortable going on a short plane ride, but it's really about flexibility of people being able to take advantage of remote working, of flexible school schedules, to go a little bit closer to home and discover communities right in their backyards.
So is there going to be a rush on Airbnb? So you better make your reservations early?
Absolutely. Book early, book now. And for hosts, this is really interesting because it could mean a potential windfall for Airbnb hosts. And if you're thinking about becoming a host, it could mean a windfall for you too. So right here in Texas, rural hosts have earned a total of over $151 million since the start of the pandemic last month. And the typical rural host in Texas has earned more than $9,000 in that same time period. It's incredible. So looking ahead to the summer, given the fact that we're expecting this massive travel rebound and people visiting more off the beaten path destinations, it's a great time to start hosting, especially if you live in a rural community.
How do they get started as a guest and a host?
So you can visit Airbnb.com, where you can find a place to stay or book an online experience. And if you're interested in becoming a host and learning more about what that could entail, visit Airbnb.com/host. There's actually a really neat tool on that page. It's called What's My Place Worth? And you enter in some super basic information like your zip code, how many rooms you have in your home, and the tool will estimate how much you could potentially earn as an Airbnb host. So definitely recommend checking out Airbnb.com/host.
Gessney Blackwell, you started the weekend off good. I'm sure I can see people already trying to get online and make reservations. Have a great weekend.
Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.